Hello everyone, welcome to our virtual class. Today we are going to learn next part of forms of market part 3. What we learned in previous video, we learned the market classification of market, that is three types of classification of market. First is on the basis of time, on the basis of place, and on the basis of competition. So let's start we revise the chapter what we learned in our previous. Forms of market. Introduction: what is market? Then definition of market. Classification of market on the basis of place, local market, then national market, international market, on the basis of time, that is very short period, long period, very long period, and on the basis of competition. There are two types of competition: perfect competition and imperfect competition. We learned last video perfect competition. Pre-entry and exit features, that is features of perfect competition. We learned in our previous lecture, that is the definition of market, classification of market. There are three classification of market, that is on the basis of time, on the basis of place, and on the basis of competition. See, on the basis of time, that is short period, long period, very long period. Today we are going to learn next part, that is equilibrium price. What is equilibrium price? Equilibrium price is the price at which quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied. The price of the product under perfect competition is influenced by both buyers and sellers, and equilibrium price is determined by the interaction of demand and supply force. Means here, equilibrium price means what? Where the demand and supply of the commodity is equal. In that case, that price is equilibrium price. Now we learn see the schedule of this equilibrium price. Price, quantity demanded and quantity supplied. Okay, when the price is 5, suppose when the price is 5, quantity demanded is 100 and quantity supplied is 500. If price falls, that is 4, quantity demanded also increase. As we know that there is a inverse relationship between demand, price and demand. So when the price falls, the quantity demanded is increased, that is 200, and quantity supplied is decrease. As we know that there is a direct relationship between price and quantity supplied. So when the price falls, quantity supplied also falls. If price falls, that is 3, quantity demanded increases, that is 300, and quantity supplied also decreases, that is 300. Price 2, quantity demanded is increases, that is 400, quantity supplied decreases, that is 200. If price is 1, quantity demanded is 500 and quantity supplied is 100. What we see here, when price is 5, quantity demanded is 100 and quantity supplied is 500. But when the price falls, that is 4, quantity demanded also increases and quantity supplied are decreases. See, here quantity demanded is less than quantity supplied. DD means quantity demanded is less than quantity supplied. Here at price 3, quantity demanded is 300 and quantity supplied is also 300. So it is a equilibrium price. 3 is the equilibrium price at the level of 300. Demand at the level of quantity demanded 300 and the level of quantity supplied is 300. So here DD is equal to SS. It is a equilibrium price, where quantity demanded and quantity supplied both equal at the same price, that is called equilibrium price. See here, when the price falls 2 and 1, quantity demanded is 400 and supplied is 200. Means here, quantity demanded is greater than supply. DD is what? Greater than supply. I hope you are understood. See the graph. Here, x-axis indicates quantity demanded. And quantity supplied. Y-axis indicate the price. ओके, 100, 200, 300, 400 एंड 500. यस, सेम प्राइस, 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड 5. सेम प्राइस, इक्वल प्राइस. व्हाट इज इक्वल प्राइस? दैट इज 3. 3 इज द इक्विलिब्रियम प्राइस एंड 300 इज द इक्वल DD. Demand curve is up and it is SS, supply curve. This is E is the equilibrium point. Here demand DD curve, DD is less than SS, that is supply less than SS, and here SS is less than DD, means demand DD is greater than SS. E is a equilibrium price, that is DD equals to SS. See, when the price one quantity demanded and supplied 100. OP, that is OP is the equilibrium price, and OQ is the equilibrium quantity demanded and quantity supplied. The next part, imperfect competition. What is imperfect competition? It is a competitive market situation where there are many sellers, but they are heterogeneous, means dissimilar goods, as opposed to the perfect competitive market scenario. As the name suggests, competitive markets that are imperfect in nature, means imperfect competition, it is a worldwide, it is a real world competition. Today, if the seller and buyers follow it, imperfect competition has three parts, that is monopoly, oligopoly and monopolistic competition. We learn that first part is monopoly. According to What is monopoly? According to Chamberlain, a monopoly refers to a single firm which has control over the supply of a product which has no close substitute. What is monopoly? Mono means single and poly means seller. Means monopoly means single seller. In monopoly market, there is a single seller of the product. So there is no competition and there is no any close substitute. See the example, Indian Railway and electricity, they have no any it is a single seller. First point, there is a features of monopoly, single seller. In a monopoly market, there is a single seller or a single producer. Under monopoly, he has no rivals and he faces no competition. Here, what is rivals? Rivals means competitors. Competitors. Here only one seller, so there is no competitor. They not faces any competition with other firms. There are only single seller and large buyers. Next is no close substitute. There are no close substitutes for the commodity sold in the market. Likewise, other firms may not produce the same product. Hence, monopolists do not face any competition. There is only one seller, so no any competitor with other firms. There are no close substitute for the commodity sold in the market. Likewise, other firms may not produce the same product, hence monopolies do not face any competition. In this market, buyers have no choice. They have to entire buy product from the monopolist or go without it. Barriers to entry. The monopolist has complete hold over the market supply. He is the sole producer of their commodity. Therefore, entry barriers such as natural, economic, technological or legal do not allow competitors to enter the market. With the example, patents, brand loyalty and reputation, license and permits, highly specialized machinery, then marketing cost, economics. What is the entry of the drivers is restricted due to patents, license and permits and marketing cost. Government not allow without license of the to the market. Government not allowed to the firm. Next, control over the market supply. Under monopoly, the entry of other firm is strictly restricted. The seller has complete hold over the supply in the market. Such provision protects the monopoly power. In a monopoly, there are single seller. So, and the barriers of entry and exit also. So the entry of other firms is strictly restricted. Because of legal barriers, technological barriers. Next is price taker. Price taker. The firm under monopoly is price maker. It is not a price taker. Monopoly is a price maker. He can charge any price for the commodity as he has complete control over the supply of the product. He can fix the fixed price whatever he want to his product. The example of price maker, he fix their price, their product's price whatever he want. Next is price discrimination. This implies charging different prices for the same product to different buyers. Price discrimination means it is implies charging different prices for the same product to different buyers. The monopolist succeeds in increasing his profit by adopting the technique of price discrimination. Types of price discrimination, that is product quality. Better quality, higher price. If you purchase a better quality product, then you cost high price. Then next, labels, higher prices for branded product and lower prices for unbranded products. That is, unbranded products means that is local product. If you purchase local product, you cost low price, less price, and if higher prices for branded product. Next is size, large size, higher price, and small size, that is lower price. Next is time, off season rates for seasonal products, for example umbrella. Next, personal income, that is economic status of a particular person, that is डॉक्टर्स फीस, डॉक्टर्स चार्ज, डॉक्टर चार्ज डिफरेंट प्राइस फॉर द डिफरेंट पेशेंट. नेक्स्ट इज एज एंड जेंडर, चिल्ड्रन फेयर एंड कंसेशनल रेट्स टू लेडीज. देन मिलिट्री स्टेटस, लोअर एडमिशन चार्ज एंड कोटा फॉर देम इन यूनिफॉर्म, स्टेटस ऑफ बायर्स, कंसेशंस टू कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट गेट कंसेशन इन बस पास और रेलवे पास. देन यूज ऑफ प्रोडक्ट, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चार्जेस फॉर डोमेस्टिक यूज एंड कमर्शियल यूज. फॉर डोमेस्टिक यूज देर इज अ लो चार्ज फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड कमर्शियल यूज देर इज अ हाई चार्ज ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. Next is no distinction between firm and industry. Under monopoly, there is only one seller. There is no distinction between the firm and the industry. Thus, under monopoly, the firm is an industry. Means here, industry and industry means there is a group of firms. They are producing a same product. Next is oligopoly. As we see that there are three types of competition: monopoly, oligopoly, and monopolistic competition. The monopoly, it is a market structure with a small number of firms, none of which can keep the others from having significant influence. That is oligopoly. Oligo means few and poly means seller. Like that, monopoly, mono means single and poly means seller, single seller. As the same, oligo means few and poly means seller, few sellers. In this market, there are few sellers. That is monopoly, one firm or one producer. But in oligopoly, there are two or more firms. For example, mobile service providers, you see the picture. There are numbers of mobile service provider. Features of oligopoly: few firms or sellers. Under oligopoly market, there are few firms or sellers. These few firms dominate the market and enjoy a considerable control over the price of a product. As you see the picture, there are few sellers of gas agencies, like gas agencies, Bharat Gas Agency and Honda. Next is interdependence. The seller has to be cautious with respect with any action taken by the competing firms, since there are few sellers in the market. If any firm makes the change in the price, all other firms in the industries also try to follow the same to remain in the competition. Means interdependence means suppose one firm can change the price of their product, the same other firms also change the price of their products. Next is advertising. It is a powerful instrument in the hands of oligopolist. A firm under oligopoly can start an aggressive and attractive advertising campaign with the intention of capturing a large part of the market. Advertising is the most important feature in this market, that is oligopoly market, because of advertising they able to follow all the competitions. Next is entry barriers. The firm can easily exit from the industry whenever it wants, but has to face certain entry barriers such as government license, patents, etc. Means the firm can easily exit from the industry. In oligopoly, firms can easily exit from the market, but the entry is very difficult to them because of that entry barriers, as we learn in previous in monopoly, that is government license, patents, etc. lack of uniformity. There is a lack of uniformity among the firms in terms of their size. Some firms may be small, while others may be of bigger size. See the picture. There is a restaurant and there is a pan shop, like a tapri. Second example, hospital and a clinic. Next point is uncertainty. There is a considerable element of uncertainty in this type of market due to different behavior patterns. Rivals may join hands and cooperate or may try to fight each other. Rivals means competitors. Competitors cooperate with each other, means other firms. They cooperate each other, maybe, or maybe try to fight each other. This is assignment. You write this assignment in your notebook. First is define, that is imperfect competition, price discrimination, equilibrium price, and interdependence. And the question is, explain the meaning of perfect competition with its features. Next, we learn next topic in next period, that is monopolistic competition.